It's me again, your boy DeAndre Hood, back with another vlog. How did I go from this to this? Let's talk about it. So pretty much growing up, I was a pretty skinny kid. I played sport pretty much all throughout school. We started lifting weights in about sixth grade all the way to high school, and I did not take weightlifting seriously. I was a pretty good athlete, so I always thought that would just be enough to get by. However, after high school, I went to go play college football. In my freshman year, that summer, I found something out. I should have took weightlifting a lot more seriously because I was probably the smallest guy on the team. Everybody was bigger than me. Even the other incoming freshmen was bigger than me. Offseason came around. I didn't like my position coach at all. I really didn't think that he was going to ever play me or even give me a chance. So I quit the football team. Pretty much what I did and all this free time I had was I found the gym. And when I say I found the gym, I really found the gym. I was in the gym every day on a consistent basis, and I was dedicated. To be honest, when I first started working out, I mean, I really didn't have like a certain type of routine. I was just going in there. I was working out consistently. I was putting the right food in my body, and I definitely saw results. I saw a huge difference. Yeah, even whenever I went back home, like for the summer or Christmas break, my family was like, man, you're getting big. Even people around campus saw me after I quit football, and everybody just said I was getting so much bigger. And this is after I quit football. So about a straight year of strict weightlifting, dieting, I ended up transferring to a school in Oklahoma, and I started playing football again. And this time when I showed up, I definitely wasn't the smallest person. I was a okay average size for a receiver. I wasn't the biggest, but I definitely wasn't the smallest this time around. I was still lifting weights, but it just seemed like it was harder to, it just seemed harder to get even bigger than what I was. It's almost like I hit a plateau. After my senior year came around, I went to grad school and I still had one more year left for eligibility. And went to a school in Nebraska because I had a new weightlifting trainer and everything like that. And after working out with him for about 4 months, I saw another huge difference, another huge peak. And the biggest difference with him is that we were doing full body workouts 4 days a week. So I was getting plenty of rest in between workouts, and I saw a huge difference. After grad school, after college football, after my NFL combine, I was pretty much back to no football again, and I joined the military, and I ended up getting deployed. Once I got on deployment, that's when I really focused back to working out, and I started working out even harder, and I started working out smarter. I started doing a lot more research, on food, what I should be putting in my body, the type of workouts that I should be doing to help me gain the most amount of muscle as fast as I can. I ended up switching to a push-pull leg workout, 6 days a week, 1 day of rest. And the biggest thing that I probably switched in this workout as well, I started to add calisthenics, weighted calisthenics. So I'm doing weighted pull-ups, weighted dips. Went back to the basics. I just benching, deadlifting, squatting, front squatting, and I saw a huge difference. This is definitely the biggest that I have been. I got the juice, can tell just how I'm stunting. Can't nobody tell me nothing, cause you know I got the juice. The crazy thing about that is I don't weigh the most I ever had, but I look the biggest I ever had, which means I got nice lean muscle. Tell them I got the juice, I got the juice, you can tell just how I'm stunting. Can't nobody tell me nothing, cause you know I got the juice. I'm doing this with pretty much crappy food on deployment, not really a lot of protein, so I can just imagine when I go back home and I stay on this workout how much bigger I can even get. And here's the video up top, just pretty much showing just exactly how I look today. You'll see me flexing, not flex. I feel like fitness people should show their body when they're not flexing, just their natural body, so people can get a realistic idea of how they look. When you're going on this fitness journey, do not compare yourself to others. Everyone has their own race, their own competition, and your biggest competition is always going to be yourself. The gym is the only place that is not going to lie to you. The gym is the only place to where everything that you put in that you will get out and you will see results. And to all my females watching this video, do not compare yourself to Instagram models. The reason that I say that is because a lot of them, that's just edited picture. Some of them have surgery, and I'm not promoting surgery at all. Keep your natural, beautiful body. Go to the gym, go work out, eat right, love yourself first. And you might be a female watching the video right now, like, he don't know what he's talking about when it comes to the female body. But hey, if you don't take my word for it. Take my homegirls right here. She worked out consistently, dedicated, she ate right, and now look at her. I'll leave her contact information down below in the description if you want to contact her. Yeah, yeah. And I promise you, you will see results. Like I said, I went from this to this while working hard, being dedicated. And trust me, it is a long journey. And this fitness thing doesn't happen overnight. It took me 7 years to get to the place to where I am now, and I'm still not satisfied. I'm still going to the gym. I'm still learning new things. But I promise you, in due time, you will get those results that you've been waiting for. And if you're on your own fitness journey, leave a comment. If you haven't started your own journey yet, get out there. If this is your first time watching my video, make sure you subscribe. If you did like this video, hit the like button. Make sure you ring that bell so you get notified every time that I drop a video. Make sure you keep watching out for the channel. Make sure you keep watching out for new videos. I have plenty of workout videos, males and females, vlogs, and tutorials coming up. Thanks for watching. Peace. Fucking flies, man. Shit.